One-year-old Willis Stephenson was born shortly before the pandemic began. And over in the UK, her grandparents are anxious for a visit.
They're dying to see them. Like, they change so much when they're so young. And it's really sad. It's sad that, you know, the grandparents are missing out on all this time and all this development and, you know, all the funny things that they do.
But while mom and dad will soon receive their second COVID-19 vaccine dose, Willa and her three-year-old brother remain unprotected. For the Stephensons, it means putting any plans for international travel on hold.
To get in the airplane with our kids, not vaccinated, definitely makes us a bit anxious.
Still, after 14 months of restrictions, many families are eager to make travel plans.
Right now, there's been a huge demand ever since the announcement of last week where the quarantine is going to be lifted for future travel.
Except that announcement was for Canadians who are fully vaccinated. Kids under 12 likely won't have that option until next year. Until then,
kids will be protected by having the adults around them vaccinated and also by having less COVID in the community as a whole.
International travel is a little more complicated. Kids may be less likely to become seriously ill from COVID, but they could still import new variants.
It's important for we as Canadians to remember that although we're in a good place right now with that third wave coming right down, there are many places in the world where COVID-19 pandemic is still raging.
Concerns Kellner says could be addressed with country-specific travel guidance for families, which could include additional screening and quarantine time for unimmunized kids. The federal government is expected to update international travel and border restrictions soon. Families like the Stephensons hoping those rules provide them with some clarity. Heather Urix-West, Global News, Calgary.